I've seen many young people, well, people of all ages actually, walk away from God for this point alone. They want answers when the world is falling apart. Yes, sometimes they have caused the problems, the bad choices they have made. But other times, life happens. And they've tried this whole God thing. They've called out to Him, begging for an answer. They have prayed for doors to open. They have prayed for circumstances to change. They have prayed for hope and healing. They have gotten nothing. And they question, maybe they didn't pray hard enough. Maybe they didn't pray long enough. Maybe they didn't pray the right prayer or use the right words. Maybe they didn't confess their sins. Maybe they didn't wait long enough. Maybe whatever. And inside their mind, they're stressing out and they just don't know what to do or what to think or what to believe. And since God did not show up like He did for people here in the Scriptures, does He care? Is He even there? So I know if I even look out into this congregation, there are people on both sides of the spectrum in this journey with God. Some here today who say, yes, I'm confident. I speak with God. I talk with God each and every day. I'm alive and well with Jesus. And other people said, I've tried, and I haven't heard nothing. I'm waiting for something. He has not spoken to me. And you just want to give up on your journey with God. But friends, no matter where you are in your journey with this, I want to share a couple thoughts that I do believe will help you grow in your faith and your prayer life with God. First, pray for the Holy Spirit's guidance in your life. Whatever you're going through, pray for the Holy Spirit's guidance in your life. And I know we sometimes say that, but when you actually think about the prayers that we sometimes pray, I'll be honest, sometimes I just pray those prayers and they just come out. And I will never ask for God's Spirit to lead and guide me. And that is so important for each one of us to do. Pray for the Holy Spirit's guidance. When you look at these believers in Scripture, in the book of Acts, they have it hard. I know sometimes like we feel like we have it hard, and sometimes we may. But no doubt these guys have it hard. They have given everything up for Jesus. They've given up their jobs, their families, their safety, their lives. Yes, they have made mistakes along the way, but they were forgiven men and women for God that were going all in. They were being persecuted for their faith. Imagine waking up each and every day wondering, am I going to go to jail because of what I believe? If they talk about Jesus, if they heal someone, basically do good things, they're going to be put in prison. And they don't know if they're going to be released or if that will be the end of their life, if they will be killed in prison. They don't know God's plans from day to day, but they're praying for the Holy Spirit to give them boldness. They're praying for boldness to do the unknown. And they don't know what's going to happen, what conversations they're going to have, or who's going to oppose them. But because of their boldness for God, God allows miracles to happen. They are following what I believe is Spirit-led momentum. Amen. Spiritual momentum. So friends, if you pray for the Holy Spirit and begin acting upon the convictions of your mind, I believe you will not only find more peace and confidence about the life that you live, but you will also begin to see prayers being answered, houses being shaken in different ways.
Hi, I'm Dave Ferguson. I'm the pastor of the Collegedale Church here on the campus of Southern Adventist University. You know, it seems to me this world is a mess more than ever. And in the midst of it, the questions that are boiling up, we wonder, does Jesus have anything relevant to say about the problem in my life, the difficulty you're struggling with? I think He does. And I'd like to welcome you to subscribe to this YouTube channel as we explore the relevance of Jesus Christ in the everyday life of you and me. So subscribe, click the button.